Hello children, again I have come with a new video. Now today we are going to learn science. You ever gone to the zoo, right? There you all are looking different animals, birds, insects, right? And you are enjoying zoo, right? So, and sometimes you give food also to the animals. But have you ever think that okay, I'll go deep and study about the animals, what is their feeding habit, how do they breathe, right? So we have never thought about that, we are just enjoying. So today I'm going to teach you about the world of animals, right? So now children, I will not teach you monotonous, this is that, no. Today I will teach you something in a different way, that is, you will learn this chapter by integration of R. Yes, sahi suna. Ye aapko pura chapter mein art aur craft ki tarah mein padhane wali hu. Taki aapko it is very easy for you to understand. But the different things what I have used, I have made all the things the best out of waste. Suppose you want to go to your friend's birthday. Now in this way, situation is very bad. So in this situation, we cannot go and purchase something. Suppose the friend is living nearby your house. So at that time, what you can do? You can make one gift box. Right, in that gift box, any subject material by learning this art and craft, they will teach you that way. So that way, if you are gifting, I am sure ki he or she will be very happy that at least he or she learned one chapter of a particular subject. So all these skills I will teach you today. So let us start the world of animals. Now the earth is a home to all the variety of plants and animals, right? So today we are going to learn about the animals. So first we will learn about habitats. Before teaching the habitats, I will show you the gift box. See, now if I will open this magical box, it's a gift as I told you. I will remove all the teaching aids related to this chapter and I can give to my friends. Right? So the same way you can do it. See, remove. Abhi isme se main har ek teaching aid nikalungi and that way my entire chapter will be done. Okay, so first of all, what do you mean by habitat? Habitat means the animals naturally found or where they live, right? That is called the habitat. You can make your own notes by making the mind map like this. So first one, if some animals live in forest, right? Some live in desert. Okay. Then some live in polar region. Some in ocean. Some in fresh water. So this way you can draw mind map and you can remember it. Forest. It's a place, it's a vast region with the dense plants and trees. So which animals live there? Tiger, lion and so many animals, right? So this way you can learn about the forest. Now desert. Desert, it's a sandy place where they are getting very less rainfall, right? And the temperature is very high, hot, right? So in that type of region, only particular animals live which they can bear the more temperature. Which are those animals? Like camel, then scorpion, right? And tortoise. So they live, they can live in desert area also. Now the next polar region. So very cold place, right? So, for only particular animals which can bear the very cold, right? Thandi sahan kar sakta hai. Those animals only can live in polar region like penguin, polar bear, then walrus, penguin, owl, polar bear, right? Then walrus, etc. They live in polar region, right? Now this polar region is near north and the south poles on the earth, right? So there you can see ice and snow. So only these animals live there. Now after that ocean. In the ocean, see, it is a very vast continuous body of a saline water. What do you mean by saline water? Salty water. So in this salty water, which type of animals, which animals live? Like whale, dolphin, right? Octopus, etc. So these animals can live in ocean. After that, fifth one is fresh water. So in fresh water, it is mild salt. It is not salty like ocean, right? So here, fish, which animals can live? Fish, then duck, crane, right? Salamander, crane, toad, salamander, right? Etc. So now see, with the mind map, habitat, forest, desert, polar region, ocean, and fresh water. So now small recap of this habitat by crab. You can make this. See now what you can see here, what I have written, habitat, right? But if I will open it, Khulja Sim Seed, right? Then what I have written here, first is forest, then desert, then polar region, ocean, and fresh water. This you can keep it in your pocket. You can play also with your family, with your friends. Now I will close it. Band ho ja sim sim. Right? Habitat. So this way also we can recall all these the names and we can remember it. Understood? So you can also make this way and learn it. Now we will learn about different body coverings in animals. So body coverings. Now these also how you will remember, first draw mind map in your book and you can remember the different body covering. Now see body covering, then here you can uses, animals and uses, right? So now first body covering is your scales. First body covering, scales. Name of the animals. Which animals are having scales? For example, snake, then lizard, right? Now children, even we have a body covering, our body is also covered with the skin and the hair. It protects us from heat, cold, right? And wherever we go out, so from the hot sun also heat, right? The same way, animals are also having different body coverings, protect the underneath skin and it prevents loss of water in scales. It prevents loss of water, right? And second thing is protects the underneath skin, right? Now second is feather. Birds, all the birds, you can see the feathers. Any birds you take, right? What is the use of feathers in the birds? Helps them to fly, Second, keep them warm. Right? So, this way feathers help the birds. Now, the third thing is the shells. Which animals are having shells? Have you seen the snail? Snail, then tortoise. Tortoise, snail, etc. They are having shell. Now, how do they help them? It protects them from enemies, right? Because they are small. So, it protects them from enemies. Now, next is, last is fur. Fur, for example, yak, deer, and sheep, right? That fur, it keeps them warm and protects from rain and cold, right? Understood. Now, this way also we can draw table and we can remember this. And now it's turn by learning arts. So see, घर में आपके wall hanging हो गया, तो आप wall hanging बना सकते हो. Now here I have used this. This is the I was having the old wallet, but this is the artificial leather. These are also artificial feather. And the wool I was having, that's the same wool I have used. By using this, my intention is not to harm the animals. I don't want to harm the animals. That is why it is artificial. And my message is also that we are not supposed to harm the animals by using the real things made of animals, feathers or scales. See, I have one more extra thing. You can keep your things, pen, whatever here in this wall hanging, right? So here I have put the snake's photo. Second is feather, peacock I have made, right? Then third is shell. I made the tortoise out of this coconut shell. Coconut ka jo shell hota hai na, uske paise, aur ye walnut shell. And these are the different shells which we can found in the ocean and water, right? So with the help of that I have made this. And last is fur. From sheep we get wool. So, I have tried to make you understand by making this simple craft things, and you can remember this way. So, now next is feeding habitats, right? Feeding habitats. In this chapter, we are going deep to the animals, study how they feed, how they eat, how they breed, that way. So now the next is feeding habitats, right? All the animals are having different feeding habits, right? Most of there are three kinds of animals. Like first is herbivorous, next is carnivores, in that scavengers. And third one is omnivores. You all are learning every year from the first standard. Herbivores means plant eating animals like cow, sheep, goat, giraffe, etc. Right? Now they have different types of teeth. Means their front teeth are sharp. Right? With the help of their front teeth, they bite. Then, with the help of their broad teeth, which is behind, they chew the food this way, right? So, this way the herbivores are having their teeth. Front teeth are sharp. With the help of that, they bite the food. And beside that, with the help of their broad teeth, they chew the food. Next is carnivores. Carnivores, the animals which eat flesh of other animals. So how should be their teeth? Their front teeth are pointed, sharp, right? With the help of that sharp teeth, they tear the fleshes of animals. Now in that scavengers, few birds like vulture, carnivore animals like tiger, lion, etc. Then scavengers like vulture, hyena, and wolf. What do they eat? They eat the flesh of dead animals. जो मरे हुए animals है उसका and the dead plants, right? Dead animals. So scavenger like vulture, hyena, wolf, they eat the flesh of dead animals. Now the next is omnivores. Omnivores means the animals, those who eat plants also directly or indirectly, and those who eat the flesh of other animals also, like even the human being, man, they are also omnivores. We are also animals, right? So man, then crow, then squirrel. So now if you want to learn these animals, so we can again gift this way. Now in this I have made the flesh cards, right? You can show the artificial animals which you are having, which I have shown in my earlier videos also. Understood? Adaptation on that I have shown, insects and that. You can watch that also. So now in that herbivores, I have given the picture of giraffe, then carnivores, lion, then scavengers. See here, vulture, and last is omnivores. I have given the picture of crow. So this way entire package you can gift it to your friend so that he or she can learn at least one chapter thorough. Now next is breathing organs in animals. Breathing organs. In animals, see, different animals breathe through different organs, right? So let us discuss about the different organs in different animals. So first one is spiracles. Now spiracles means all the insects, how they breathe through small openings in their body, right? They breathe through that way. Simple, you have to remember this way. Table, you can make your own table, right? I'm just giving you the idea. You all are creative. You can create your own idea and you can learn this. Now the second one, insects means all the insects like butterfly, ants, cockroach, etc. Second, gills. Now gills, obviously aquatic animals like fish, right? Here I will write frog also. Frog lives in water also. Frog lives in on land also. That is why he is called amphibian animal. So frog, when he is in water, it breathe through gills, and when he is on the land, it breathe through its lungs. And fish, they are having gills. So with the help of that gills, they just paddle and move. And in the water, how they breathe, it help, these gills help them to absorb the oxygen. Oxygen dissolved in water. Pani mein jo oxygen rehta hai na, wo absorb karte. So with the help of gills, so that way they breathe. So it helps these animals to absorb oxygen dissolved in water, right? Now the third one is lungs. Now lungs means we human beings, right? Humans, then reptiles, they also break through lungs, reptiles, birds, right? Humans means even mammals like whale is a mammal, right? Mammals means warm-blooded animals. So whale, though it lives in water, it breathes through lungs, right? So mammals. Now, what is the function of the lungs? Is to transport oxygen. Even we breathe, so our lungs transport oxygen while breathing, and which is inhaled through the nose and to the blood, and to remove the carbon dioxide from our body, right? So to transport oxygen inhaled through nose and to remove carbon dioxide, right? So this way, these are the different breathing organs in different animals. Now these also I can show you with the craft material. Now look, here I have made the diary. English mein aapko diary likhni hoti hai na, so I have made here diary, and see how I have done breathing organs in animals. See all the animals. Now first is spiracle. See cockroach, this way small openings they are having, with the help of that they breathe. Then second is gills. See here gills, right? And the next is lungs. Lungs, we are also having lungs, and with the help of that we inhale oxygen and we remove carbon dioxide. Now along with that I have tried to show small activities also. See how we breathe this way. Inhale, exhale. So lungs also work this way. Understood? Now next is movement in animals. Different animals move different way, right? So we will see movement in animals, right? The movement of animals, when they move from one place to another, is known as locomotion. What it is known as? Locomotion. So now different animals use different body parts for their movement. So first here we will write animals, and here we can write the movement. So in that, first of all, insects. Now insects, now look here, insects like butterfly and mosquitoes, they have one or two pairs of wings, one or two pairs of wings. With the help of that they can fly, right? And these wings help them to fly. Now the termites and lice. What do you mean by termites? आपके घर में पुराना wooden furniture होगा, उसमें कीड़े सरीखा होगा, वो सड़ गया है. That is called termites. And lice, बाल में जिसकी झूं होती है ना, that is called lice. So termites and lice move by crawling. This way called crawling. They don't have legs, so they do not walk. So they move by crawling. Then ants and cockroaches. Cockroaches सबने देखा होगा. It flies hook and the ant and cockroach they walk. चलते हैं. Right? And grasshopper. Grasshopper using its long hind legs. Hind legs यानी पीछे के legs. ऐसे long पीछे के legs उसके बड़े होते. With the help of that it hops, jumps करके ऐसे move करते. Right? So this is about the insects. Now second is reptiles. Reptiles means snakes, right? Lizard, cockroaches, right? Use various forms of locomotion. Like cockroaches, as I told you, they walk also. Sometimes they fly a little bit also. Even the snakes. Snakes and so what they use various forms of locomotion and some of them have legs, right? So even lizards crawl also and sometimes it walks also and they have legs and some use their scaly skin jo scales hote hain maine aapko bataya tha usme scaly skin to move by crawling this way crawl karte scaly things maine art mein aapko bataya tha right. Then third one is the birds. How birds they can help their wings, right? Their birds can hop also, they can fly also. Some birds are flying high in the sky, some birds do not fly like emu, ostrich because of their heavy bodies. They simply hop. So these are the different movement in animals. Now how you will remember this? See, now here I have made the art thing fan. Garmi ki season hai, summer. Now movement in animals. This is earthworm. See, this way it moves. Then insects, as I have shown you, different insects move with different body parts. Then reptiles, they crawl. Then birds. Then terrestrial animals. Yes, fourth is terrestrial animals. They all terrestrial animals, they walk. Fourth is terrestrial animal, they some animals use four legs, hind legs and fore limbs both, and they walk. Some animals run also, right? So we are also human being and so we are walking with our legs. So most of the animals use all four limbs to walk or to run, right, for their movements. So and the last is aquatic animals. Aquatic animals, right? So aquatic animals like turtles use limbs to swim and frog use when it is in water. What? So is web feet, right? Web feet to swim and frog ke aage ki jo feet hote hain wo swimming mein use karta hai. And when it is on land to uske jo piche ke pair hote hain, right? So that time hind legs he used to hop, and fish have fins to move in water. Now next is migration. What do you mean by migration? See, you must be knowing this word from last year. In such a pandemic year, this all the workers, they are migrating from one place to another place because here they are getting scared. Abhi bhi yahi chal raha hai, jo mazdoor hai wo migrate kar rahe hai apne gaon mein. So this way, so the migration means the movement of animals, right, from one place to another place in search of food to protect themselves from enemies or natural calamities like earthquake, feed droughts, right? So this is called migration. Migration is closely associated with the birds. You must have heard in the old region some few birds come from another country, right? here because there it's a very cold place, so they just migrate here, right? They migrate twice in a year, especially in spring and the autumn season. The birds which are migrate from one place to another, they are called migratory birds, and the birds which do not migrate, they are called resident birds. Now this you can show by, see here I have made the photo frame. I'm showing you the birds, see migration of birds, butterflies, and see human beings. This I told you, now few of the workers, they are migrating. Now you have seen with the help of art and craft, we have learned the entire chapter, the world of animals. Now same type of video, another video, if you want to watch, then click here, adaptation of survival in animals, right? So, and finally, if you like the video, then please share it to your friends, your neighbors, and subscribe it so that my all new videos, you will get the notification and you will be the first to see my videos. Thank you.